not to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when they're coming to take your freedoms.
How you doing?
Good, how are you doing?
Good.
Come on in, what can I do for you? For a little bit?
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
How you doing?
Huh? You can take off. Come on.
Ah, okay.
So, the reason why I'm stopping by here today right now, I've been here before. You know,
yeah.
Well, today we had a burglary incident happen across the street, not too far from here.
Okay.
And one of your sons was mentioned as a suspect because he's one of the only ones that's been over there, and we assume it's a child because, or at least the kid, about JoJo's age. There was some marijuana taken from the residence along with the bong, and the only people that would be aware of where that specific location was would be JoJo and this individual's, what would be potentially his daughter, okay? And in this case, he suspects it's him because JoJo would know his schedule of leaving the house.
Okay, well, you do understand that Joseph's on house arrest.
I do.
And I'm pretty sure I know the individual that you're talking about because that scenario was brought to my attention months ago.
Yes, which is the second time this has happened, apparently.
Oh, this is a second occurrence,
yeah,
you're saying?
Yeah, not the first time. This is now a new occurrence.
Okay.
So, someone actually broke into the back end of his house and got in and took the marijuana and a bong and then left. Why I'm here talking with you, because I know that you wanted to be cooperative with us.
Oh, yeah. No, I'll tell you, if my kids are involved with stealing, they're going to pay hell.
Okay.
We work for everything we get, or we ask for help, or we don't steal.
With JoJo, with your permission, though, I'd like to chat with JoJo, and maybe even with your help, if he doesn't have a reasonable expectation.
I can't allow that because of his mental health status, because when Joseph is in a position where he's intimidated, and police do intimidate him, his mental health issues will cause him to send signals out that to police officers, normally profiling somebody would indicate that he is guilty. And me, knowing that it's a mental health condition, I'm not going to put him in that position. If you had other evidence to show me, like fingerprints or something else, or a witness that said they saw him on the property or something else, and then obviously I would be, but on an allegation, I'm not going to put my son in that situation.
I'm definitely not looking to see.
Well, I know I don't really care, honestly, what you're looking for and whether you think that you're going to intend to intimidate him. I'm not saying that you intend to intimidate him. I'm saying when Joseph is put in those situations where he, especially if he's not guilty, his reactions are very angry, very violent.
Well, let's bypass that. Let's bypass that scenario of me even talking to him in the first place. Okay.
Okay.
Why don't you go take a look through his room or anything that you want? If he doesn't have a reasonable expectation of
privacy. Well, you know what? I did. This is the, it was, I don't know, a week or so ago when rumor on the street got through the MAC PD that Joseph was involved in breaking into the Happy Hut and stealing a bong. I went through the house and all known areas where they might hang out here or any other common areas, everything I could think of, and found no indications of any of that, which I don't mind. I obviously will, and I will try to talk to him about that.
Okay. Well, like I'm saying, this is our opportunity to get evidence to basically tie JoJo into something. If there's no evidence of the crime here, then that client...
If there's no evidence of him being involved in the crime at the crime scene,
I think
you mean, you're not going to come in here and try to generate evidence of a crime. You're not going to do that.
That's not the purpose.
I don't care what the purpose is. You're not going to do it.
Kevin, I'm not trying to tune you
out. I understand, but I'm going to stand by my constitutional rights, the well-being of my child, and I'm going to ask you to afford me more proof than you've come here with now before you come into my house looking for anything, before you question my children.
You're right, Kevin, there's not a whole
before you spend a whole lot
but you just
more
have to
time
listen to
here.
Why I brought up him as a friggin' suspect in the first place, okay? Because it is reasonable for this person to assume that he would be involved in this. Because he's an individual that is very much aware of where that would be. There was only one particular thing.
Other than he hasn't been at that man's house for months.
Okay.
You're overlooking a fact, sir.
Have you been home with him all day?
I've been here all day. Do I keep Joseph in my sight 24 hours a day? Obviously not. I sleep and possibilities are endless.
Okay.
But that is still not proof of any crime being committed by him.
Kevin, so... part of this, and I appreciate in the past you said you've absolutely want to be involved to make sure your kids are on the straight and narrow, okay? And I appreciate that. part of this, it's not necessarily to, well, we want to find evidence.
You're also the officer that lied to me in the front steps of the MAC PD. Yes, you did, sir.
Okay.
I have the video.
So,
would you like to review it if you haven't already?
I've seen it. Kevin,
okay, and you lied to me.
Part of this
blatantly. And you wasted my time for 25 minutes while I was trying to keep my children in line. Right, I'm just reminding you that I haven't forgotten. And I know who you are, and you're not trustworthy.
Part of this is...
Let's be civil about this and have a good
I don't need to be my time wasted by an officer. I already disrespect because he disrespected me, he lied to me, and he's not trustworthy. That has been documented. It's not an accusation. You have not done that. That's why I'm talking to you.
Okay. That's
Kevin,
fine.
Part of this is to prove that he didn't do it.
Well, I guess unless you have proof that he did, that'd be proof enough, wouldn't it?
So how are we supposed to investigate something if you're not willing to let us talk to your children? So you tell us...
I'm not willing.
You tell us that you want to cooperate...
I don't have to violate my rights because of your lack of evidence, sir.
And because you want to make sure that your kids are doing... You want to cooperate with the police. Part of cooperating with...
Bring me some proof that he hasn't done so, other than an accusation, and I will be glad to work with you if you did.
We wouldn't need your permission to talk to...
Exactly. That's the system we live in. I thought you worked for that system, sir.
I do.
Then follow the law.
I know the system better than you do.
And respect my right. Oh, really?
Yes.
Then why did you lie to me, sir?
I didn't.
Yes, you did. I asked you for a simple copy of something that you ran me around for 25 minutes and then ended up producing anyway. You're telling me that's not a lie?
This is unproductive.
You don't know the difference between a photocopy and a copy from an e-file or whatever the case? Come on.
Kevin, this scenario between you and Officer High is irrelevant.
It is relevant. He's a liar.
Well, I'm dealing with a completely different scenario here.
Okay, so I'll deal with you, not
so
him.
Deal with me, then.
You may excuse yourself, unless you feel threatened and have to protect
He's just going to stay here, okay? He's just going to chill out. He doesn't need to say anything further. But like I said,
great.
This is the opportunity right now for us to clear JoJo's name.
He is cleared. He hasn't been implicated in a crime.
Okay?
So he is clear. This isn't...
If I went on all my investigations, okay, just look at it from my perspective, okay, doing my job, like I have, and I've done this multiple times with investigations, if I get wind of information, potential suspects that'd be involved in a case, I'm going to follow up with
right.
and talk with those people, okay? If I can't be afforded the opportunity to talk with JoJo, okay, the next best thing so that we don't affect his mental instability at this point, because like you said, it's probably not the best condition for him right now in his condition that he is right now. So in order to bypass that and not traumatize the child, okay, the best case scenario to clear his name, because I have that suspicion based on the information I have with him. I think it's a reasonable suspicion, okay? Nonetheless, all right, that's not solid evidence to say that JoJo did it, but there's an accusation. We can clear his name right now if there's a consent search. If you want to help us,
sir,
you can be right there.
Sir, his name is clear until you afford proof that he's violated the law.
That's fine. Okay.
If that's fine, then you have a good day.
Well, I'm saying
this conversation is done, sir. If you have evidence that my child committed a crime, feel free to come back with a warrant.
I have a reasonable suspicion that he does. Okay. Do you understand that? Do you know what a reasonable suspicion is?
You have an accusation by an individual.
I have facts.
And
that
you
he's
yourself,
been to the house. Listen, listen
you,
Kevin,
months
just
ago,
listen.
You don't have any current information that's valid, sir.
Yes, I do. Okay, listen to the facts that he supplied.
If you did, then you'd be here with a warrant, not a plea to question and search.
If I had probable cause.
If you had probable cause.
Warrant,
if you had probable cause.
And I'm explaining to you what I have.
Right.
I have reasonable suspicion that he's involved. Okay? That's what we build cases on. We start with reasonable suspicion. Okay? If we see a guy running around town.
And your reasonable suspicion
Kevin,
is?
Let me give you an example. Okay, if we see a person who's walking up and down 4th Street checking handles of cars, okay, is it reasonable to assume that he's probably
right.
trying to get into cars?
Have you seen Joseph on the property?
Could you listen?
Has anybody seen Joseph on the property?
Do I get a point here to talk to you and explain my perspective or not?
I know your perspective, sir, and
okay.
I see that you're avoiding my questions
I'm not
very
avoiding
thoroughly.
Any of them.
You haven't answered any of them.
I haven't heard any of your questions because I'm trying to explain my side of the story first.
You haven't heard of them?
No.
Sir, your side of the story is quite clear.
Yes, I believe there's a suspicion.
You want to sidestep the process.
What's the process I want to sidestep? I want to help you, okay?
I didn't ask for your help. I'm not aware that I need your help. When I need your help, I'll call you. That's how that, I mean...
Right now, your son is a suspect in my case.
Outstanding. Do your research and find out if he's guilty. If he is, then I won't hide him from you.
I don't understand why you wouldn't help us in this case if he's... cleared name. There's not
because
be
I'm adamant
here.
That we have a system and we're all going to follow it, sir.
Okay, and in typical scenarios like this and other investigations, I've had parents cooperate with me and help me out investigations.
And so they chose to give up their rights. I don't choose to give up my rights.
Why are you fighting this? I don't understand why you're fighting the search here to help us out and to discover whether or not your son is guilty or not.
Fighting you, sir, I'm upholding my rights as a citizen of this country.
That's great, Kevin.
And a member of this community.
There's a lot of people that obviously allow us to come in and search residences if they don't have anything to hide.
Okay? And there's also a lot of people that don't want you to violate their privacy or due process or any of those things without some type of proof, sir. And we have a right to do that, and
you
are paid to uphold that. And I don't understand why you're still harassing me for upholding your rights. We'll see what the general community says then. Thank you. You are as well. This conversation is over.
Then go back
inside.
You don't want to talk to us, Kevin.
We have a right to be here on this part of the property.
Sure. If you'd like to stand outside of my door, we'll see how long you stay here. Because since I live here, it's more reasonable that I would stand here after I've asked you to leave.
There's no other wasting our time in the future saying that we'd like to cooperate with the police department when clearly you don't.
Excuse me?
You've said repeatedly, I want to cooperate with you guys. I want to make sure my...
Absolutely, but that doesn't mean I want to give up my rights on simple accusations.
I asked you
on more than one occasion, and we can review this video if you like, what your reasonable suspicion is, other than an accusation made by somebody that lives in the neighborhood who's already made that accusation months before.
I already explained to you exactly what he said to me. That makes it reasonable, okay? When he says that JoJo's been to his house, that JoJo
months ago, so that wouldn't have anything to
do
with the current.
Months ago, you said yourself that you don't keep your eyes on JoJo all the time, okay? And even when I came to you the first time about the Happy Hut accusation, there was this fact that you were sleeping.
So you failed on the Happy Hut accusation, and so you're back with another accusation, and still don't have any proof.
In fact, I'm trying to get video surveillance from the surrounding area right there. So if I get video surveillance and JoJo's on that camera, you're going to look different in this scenario.
No, then I'm going to hand him over to you to do your job.
That's understood.
And until then, I'm going to protect him under the law.
Okay, that's fine.
And the law says that you had right to come here and ask.
What I'm trying to explain to you.
And now they say you must leave.
What you're not saying.
Unless one of us is being detained.
I've already explained to you that you're free to go inside.
I don't have to go inside, though, sir. This is where I live.
Don't
you have a job to do?
You don't need to talk with me.
Okay.
I'm doing my job right now. What you're not hearing is what my reasonable suspicion is based on the facts that the guy gave me. Okay,
and I disagree. I think it's unreasonable.
Okay.
Well, you're saying that a child would have to violate conditional release, defy court orders, put himself at risk of being instantly put in the juvenile hall.
So, would it be the first time that someone hasn't done that? I know tons of kids that have done those things.
Oh, sure.
Okay, so why was...
But knowing my son, that's not reasonable. You said what's reasonable.
Yeah.
Only I, sir, would know what's reasonable in reference to my son. How long have you known my son, sir? How long have you known my son? Less than 11 months. I've raised him myself solo for over 11 years. So you're not going to be the one to dictate what's reasonable. You're absolutely right. Now, everybody's wondering why you haven't left yet.
Everybody,
you're not getting... Yes, they are.
Okay, well,
there's quite a few people here.
Yeah,
they're wondering why you haven't left yet.
Well, I can tell you that you're not going to get any support from the police department.
I'm not going to get any support. That is an admission of an attack on my family, and an admission that you will not uphold the law if we call on you. Thank you, sir. Have a good day. I'll be speaking to your chief. Bullshit.
We always come when people call.
I just heard, and so will the entire planet within the hour, that you will not support my family if we call on you.
No,
I'll have your badge, both of you. You've already lied to me and run me along when I tried to do the right thing. As far as I'm concerned, I think you're a lying, no good son of a bitch. And you're falling into that category now. You absolutely are. I've caught your PD insulting me, lying to me, targeting my family, and now you're here putting me down because I don't want to give away my rights. I don't want to compromise my child to make your job easier. Really? and you're going to look down on me, and you're going to tell me that your department is not going to support my family when we need you?
I never said that we
would. Yes, you did. Want to review the video?
Sure. Let's review over it.
Now, you'll review it on the internet the same time everybody else sees it. Have a good day.
You're taking it out of context, Kevin.
All right. Taking it out of context? We'll let the general public and your chief decide that, sir. Have a safe and wonderful evening. Fuck your system, you fucking bastards.